This is kind of interesting because this is something that EG did themselves at ESL, for example, playing the Klinks against the AM. Now EG are going to be the ones handling the AM.
Being Radiant offlane, that is a play he can go for. But
Fly, Shards nicely done, locking Samael in. The Lion Striker Raid dodged by the Snowball of Fly. This should be the death of Samael, and Complexity still the first blood.
Out it out now with the Z-Freak.
Baro Strike up, they caught out Fly, and with Laguna Blade. Smell gets a very, very quick kill. And Z-Freak's by himself inside the dire jungle.
This is why it's so risky for Complexity to go up here. It's very, very easy for EG to find these kills. They might even find Z-Freak here if there's any sort of backup. He's going to dodge the Centaur.
With the Baro Strike, that was wonderful. He can body block up Z-Freak. It's buying time for both PPD as well as Fear to come in. They want to find this kill. And there it is, over on the anti-mage. They're giving more money. Swindermelons comes in too, but there wasn't enough mana to go for the Sonic Wave. Now the regeneration is triggering off, and the Shards are locking him in. The Sonic Wave hits on three, the Blink up. He brings down PPD. Fear able to blink himself away. But you've got Universe trapped inside the river. That Centaur doesn't have mana for a stomp. They cannot get him out of the sandstorm until Blink to Scream.
Yeah, he's going to try to run here. This
is... It's actually in range of the Scream. And then the attack. Swindermelons will find the double kill. And Swindermelons even moved over to try and steal the other stack that was already prepared by EG. Snowball on top, going up to Aoi with also the Shards locking down. Aoi will drop Swindermelons right behind him. EG, it doesn't feel like they belong in any point of this map, especially when Hookshot comes in and Clockwork holding some out of the battery assault. Laguna Blade still going to come in. Universe, not sure if he wants to be part of this, and he definitely does not want to be. PPD embracing Sumail. And they could hold him there. They do drop the Winter's Curse over on Klinks. Laguna Blade burning through the Aegis of the Immortal. As Complexity, they back off. They were attempting to TP out, but Aoi lets off the Song of the Siren Chen. He's still got the Hand of God of Babel here, and who do they really want to be going on? They're looking for the opening, and it's going to be the Klinks, but the BKB, Yulsef Rub, he's going to get the BKB straight away, and then just run away to safety. Potentially could be sent back while the Anti-Mage is doing his work on the bottom lane. Took out the Tier 3 tower, and can't even cancel the TP out. Fear is away to safety, but it's the Baro Strike chasing it off to Klinks. Real trouble right now, and there it is! Will come through for the Riptide kill. And Fear, so much work on the bot lane. That tier 3 tower as well, he's gotta be happy. And they look for more actually. The Chen, Z-Freak, not out of home and host. Trying to run back up to the tree line now. He's got no TP scroll, so he's a guaranteed kill here for Evil Geniuses. Actually, even more. Fly, he's low, no mana void available, but just two hits. Okay, you know that swing? That swing which we were tossing up a little bit? I think it's really swung. Cloak on him. Is it meant to go into Maul?
I think he... Oh, that's a good question. They might feel like they need a pipe to high ground.
For now, let's look at the fight. Earlier. That's going to be Klinks attacking into Samael. Four hits. It's going to be five to get the kill with the epicenter from Universe. Runs over Complexity with the Hand of God as well. Samek repairing so much the damage. Now Fear join the fight. They will be able to curse up on the Klinks. They control him perfectly. Universe coming back in for another Baro Strike, but he's looking for more. Misses on the Baro, but Fear still looking for his kills as Song of the Siren will stop this, actually allowing the send back. That was Mumienda who got back to base, but Z-Freak and Swindermelons will not be so lucky. The Mana Void just ripping apart their life. A triple kill for Fear as Evil Geniuses, after pause number, I don't know however many, fancy footwork going left and right. Now that stun going to stop Mumienda from actually TPing out. This doesn't allow him to come back while Fear attacking the base of Complexity. They're losing their bottom racks. Mumienda, he is going to go down. They just focus him. At the same time, Klinks gets back in on the leader. They still haven't killed off this Clockwork. The Hand of God now going to work. Aoi will ensnare. And Mumienda, he survived for a very, very long time. But how much longer can he really be here? The illusions are killing him. They glimmer cape him up. Where's your vision? It is going to be there as the Baro Strike from Universe does kick in. But he's forced after away from the Klinks, Sandstorming to avoid the last attack as well. How much damage was done on bottom? A lot. The melee ranked is gone for Complexity.
And Aegis, he's hard enough for them to kill once. Twice is going
to
be
at the same time, you're about to go into like Song of the Siren as well as Epicenter. In fact, that's exactly what Aoi does. They ensure Roshan, the Aegis Ball at the hands of Fear at the same time. Mumienda, he hookshot it up so far, he's completely isolated from the rest of his team. He's dead before they even get up on the high ground near the Dire Ancients. Snowball in, they go after Aoi. At the same time, Fear locking down Swindermelons and bursting him with the Mana Void. It's a double kill for Fear. The Aegis the Immortal may trigger here, but the Klinks will end up dying do. Another triple kill for Fear as EG. They even get the Burrow Strike on Fly. He was TPing out the last moment. He'll Glimmercate, but this means the Fly can't get back to base. EG can just go for broke. Take that mid racks.
The biggest control of all up against one of the cores doesn't even have a BKB. The double Burrow Strike from Universe. Sentry was went down, so they saw him. But then the curse is over on the Queen of Pain. Yulzit through to a double life trigger, and Fear comes in. Swindermelons, it took two hits to kill him off. And this will be EG ravaging Complexity. Even with a Sonic Wave, Fear just jumps in deeper. Three hits to kill off Seafreak. More Burrow Strike supports from Universe. TBD's making sure that Fear just cannot be touched. He moves back up to play objective-based gaming to finish off the racks. While Moomita might be moving back here, Samael not affected by these cogs. Swindermelons back to front lines, but again, Universe, a double Burrow Strike. And, well, they just keep going to work. Where is AM? He has gone for a bit of a wander. He'll come back to the front lines, and this is when the game practically ends. Fly is currently hexed up, stunned, burrowed, and killed off. This is it when Swindermelons dies. It is a full rack. It's Mega Creeps for Evil Geniuses here in game number one. But Complexity, it's like they're trying to send a message for game number two. We won't give up to the bitter end. Just keep fighting. And then Laguna Blade thinks, well, maybe fighting was not the greatest idea in the world. Fly keeps trying to return out, but with a Yule Scepter up, the stun will follow in, and Fly locked, Burrow Strikes, and this should be actually Glimmer caping back past the tier 4 towers and sent back by the Chen. Complexity just won't say die.
I think EG is going to make them right now.
Forced it.
Their options are very limited. Going to snowball in Chen aggressively as a distraction. Very unusual play.
They're all dead. This is going to be the fountain dying. Complexity refusing to the bitter end to submit to Evil Geniuses. But the game says it's over. Game number one only took roughly 2 hours, but we do have game number one over with Evil Geniuses. It was a rough start for them, Sin.
Suitable 1v1 matchup, and he's again Tuss.
Yeah, that's a good strength hero.
That would be a dream.
Yeah. Ember Spirit. That is interesting.
Brought out a good fighting hero early on and works a lot better into the late
alternatively,
game.
Alternatively, could consider it, of course, on Universe Tusk. It's not that uncommon of an item on that hero.
Owie, real trouble on bottom lane. The Light Striker right from Flying was able to connect. They need more damage to kill him, however. There's a Stout Shield. But then again, with another second Light Striker Ray, Complexity open up the account. They claim first blood, and this is not the way EG wanted to start this.
It's an item build that's so effective on Timbersaw because he gets so much armor from the reactive armor.
Swindermelons is dead. The Spirit Snowball, he's only got 1 point up with the Dragon Blood. The double TPs are on the way, and it's actually Moomiander coming in. He finds Universe, but needs more damage. He's not going to find it. Dazzler's a Shallow Grave himself. Samael Spirits up, and he's actually, is that even on the high ground? I don't think that actually is. Oh, it is. It's just on the edge. He'll go up while Owie 2000 looking for some other revenge. His TP out. Will it be in time? No, it will not. Moomiander will find the kill. It was still, however, Sven also dying on the top lane during this engagement. It's the movement coming in from Complexity. If they walked a little bit further to the side, then Fear would have actually broken the smoke. But they go in deeper. They're searching for the Crystal Maiden, and this should be an easy pickoff. Just turn for the stun, but Fly a little bit too far away. Should be able to still hit the Light Strike Array, but decides, you know what, maybe not the possibility. Go Laguna as well as Slave. Samael to Spirit jumping down. He'll get the Searing Chains on Fly, who again, attempting a TP out, will not be in time. But the Sven will be able to survive. Meanwhile, on bottom lane, the push just keeps coming in. Same for mid lane. Dragon form kicks in, and Evil Geniuses, they managed to walk all the way down. In fact, they're just going to go for the snowball. Searing Chains, where's it going to come from? Samael, not enough mana for it. Even with the 3-1 charges, a very early Shallow Grave from the Dazzle. And there's not much more he can do here apart from a quick heal. Timbersaw will arrive, and Samael, no mana with the Whirling Death. But the Tusker, the shards are able to connect. He finds a kill on the DK, and now the Timbersaw's dropping as well. And EG, they brought in all their friends and had a party on Complexity's corpses.
They do have a glyph as well.
Yeah, they come in from behind. Smoke on EG Universe. And Samael, who's he go for? Who's the bigger target? And he just makes a run straight for the Dazzle. He wants him to waste the Shallow Grave over on the Dazzle. In fact, he won't even get it off. Down for the count. Owie now with the Song of the Siren keeping Sven away from him. This will waste a lot of the time of that God Strength. But now Timbersaw also coming back to fight, putting down the Sharkroom. So there's a one way to get out. But PPD just lets it go from inside the tree line. Sven, they can't walk away fast off. The shards lock him in. There's two down. And Samael's looking for more. Chasing after Moomiander. Owie ensnares back off cooldown now. He can stop Swindermelons on the run, but can they get close to the plasma field damage as well? Frostbite into a snowball, Swindermelons, that DK turned around, but Universe down for the count, 130 life still on that DK, but the a slight of fist from Samael will ensure the kill as he's looking to even go deeper than this, but maybe hold the reins and pull back on this EG attack. He has one chance. Boomiander jumping into the tree lines. Searing chase. That's a dead Tempestor. Knows just how far he can push the limits.
18 for an Ember, so definitely scary here for Complexity, who seems to be losing Swindlemelons.
Yeah, they're gonna lose more. Samael comes up. Z-Free can't get close enough to it. Swindlemelons controlled by the Walrus Punch. Still trying to stun out of here. Z-Free has to use the Cello Grave on himself. Samael just hanging around so he can slide a fist him down. Able to do so at the same time as Swindle will drop. EG momentum galore as now Spirit jump in again. He's got Slide of Fist here in chains, gets the timing for it. Samael actually stops to buy while he's looking down. The snowball comes in from Universe with a perfect sharp positioning. But Timbersaw looking for some revenge. Samael doesn't have any spirits remaining at the moment, so he can't help out that way. But PPD, the Frostbite's gonna be there. Samael again with the Spirit jump down. Slide of Fist here in chain. He's gonna get the kill on Sven. Moomy and the team, but Samael again, no spirits, but 14 one charge to the shards. The perfect positioning again from Universe. EG, it's a splendid display of Dota coming from them.
Like, all you need to do is have Sven walk up there and hit it twice. And in fact, the TPs are already coming in from EG. At the same time, it almost feels like fate. Samael's the first one. Yep, blink, stun, breathe fire. Now the God Strength need to kill him, and they do it. Owie, again, very late on that Nagasaran ultimate.
And the tower, but
Fear is here, though.
Cost them.
Fear is here. Samael's going to go for the Searing Chase. He gets Dragon Tail stun. The Snowball will buy a little bit more space here. The Breathe Fire Universe dropping low. They need to keep him up, but it's just not possible for Complexity. The Shallow Grave allowing Sven to continue to fight, but being frostbitten and sigiled and slowed, he just can't reach a target to hit it.
Oh.
So if he's not looking, getting.
Oh, the double. The double over on Fly as well as Z-Freak. It was a blink into a Slide of Fist Searing Chain. He caught both of them, and now Z-Freak tries to run away too. More Spirit jump down for Samael. Let him have the hit. It's a double kill for Ember Spirit. It's actually Samael that could basically do this solo. Leaves a defensive spirit, but he's got help. The Tuskar's there, Universe. There's your defensive spirit jump out. It was on purpose to bait Complexity to come out further. Universe actually not able to hit Fly with that snowball because of the Yule Scepter, but the Stormball connects with Laguna Blade. They get the kill on Samael. Fear will stand its ground, but he's draining a lot of damage away from that DK and looking to inflict it into the rest of Complexity. They just keep fighting with the Sharkrubs down. Moomiander now frostbitten up. He can't go anywhere until he timber-chains forward. The Glimmercate buying space for Fear just to keep running out here as Universe back to the fray. So is Samael right in the front line. Z-Free, perfect Shadow Grave, keeping himself alive. But Samael, he's got Slider Fist up as well as Searing Chains. He'll look for the double. He only gets the one that's over on the Dragon Knight, but the damage should be enough to kill him off before the TP. In fact, they just ensnare him and then bring him down. The Snowball chasing up Moomiander, the sole survivor of Complexity. And even then, he may not be that for long. Now he gets back into the base. But the creep wave's coming in, and EG will look to bottom racks. And they look for the openings. Complexity smoked up. PPD's the close one, but he's in an invis room. They didn't see him. They see Samael, but the jump is still going to be real. Samael, the Song of the Siren, the last attack! The last attack blows the Aegis.
Time that happened?
It's up there, but then the Icy Shards locking in for Complexity players. Samael, they load us off him up, but they bring him down! That's with the dieback! Complexity, this is their moment! Of a moment have they got? They haven't lost anyone. PPD, the only one bear off, but Moomiander with the Sharkrubs, he's slowing him down. The Stormbolt will keep PPD back for now, and Dragon, he's back in again after Fear, but again the Lotus off. What have they got? Fear staying alive, they Glimmer Cape him as well, they're all so low. Z-Free, they still keep fighting. Universe on the front lines doing this to Tuskar. It's a triple kill over for Fear. They catch up to Moomiander. Universe will take it. It's a team wipe. They can almost be the game right now with EG wiping Complexity out. They dealt with the Ember Spirit, but EG, they have a five-man roster.
Push them off the edge.
Yep, they're coming in. Samael the first one, Slide of Fist Searing Chain again being used over on that Timbersaw with no reactive armor, charges being built up. It hurts like hell. And Fear with the ulti on, there's another Slide of Fist Searing Chain over on Moomiander. And the blink forwards, Windermelons catches out Fear. That sentry wasn't longer there, and Owie just stops the fight. And in fact, they got Sven and DK right on top of each other. Fear triggering up that BKB. Windermelons dying so quickly. I don't even see how that Sven instantly popped, but Windermelons, the Shallow Grave keeps him alive. But Samael runs backwards. It's a double kill for him. Fly may even just burn from this. And with the shards coming in, yep, they'll be raging to take it. Complexity being farmed up inside their base. I don't know if they're going to have the same mindset about game one with this fight to the bitter end, that EG are so powerful right now, they'll kill off every single player of Complexity. The fact that Z-Freak is inside of his fountain isn't even a saving grace. They will take the mid racks, they've taken bottom racks, and they will look to take the full series here, EG, and push themselves into the semi-finals of the International 5. So Mal wants blood, and Z-Freak is almost going to give it to him.
EG, what an incredible game from them this was, actually. There are just so many small plays that add up over the course of this game. It wasn't like just one single big team fight you could say won it. All of these 3-on-3s, skirmishes, small fights, they simply outclassed Complexity on pretty much every single move in this game.
They really did.
Very well played.
It was a superb performance of Dota. You could look back at it for a while. I know a lot of EG fans will, and Complexity will have to study it.
That's how I see it. I think it's very scary. They need to win the lanes really hard because they have only single targets, and the others, they have so much
support in if there's a smoke gank. It's incredibly risky.
Big if ganks, here we go off the bat. ZYF wants to get in nice and early with the aggression. The charge comes through, but it's not going to get the kill just yet. They get done. Secret, early first blood. The trade is Arteezy also falling. A crazy skirmish erupting in the river.
But Ehum will end up backing off, so Secret, they get that first kill. Arteezy.
In fact, the real aggression is going to go the other way. With the diamond from RTK, he's hit level 6, he can deploy the egg here. Wants to hold it as long as possible, getting out the fire spirits, bringing him down. Haven't committed just yet. Will Secret be able to snipe him before he gets it off? In comes ZYF as well. The cooldown's an airball. Kuroki just skirts away from it. The charge through 1-2, hits on Lanham. Can they focus him now? They've got a brain zap. They get the kill. Now the egg, though, Secret fighting into it. But focus here with 3 heroes. Kapow! It won't actually go off.
Held it for a long time there. The backup rises up to CTY. Jump in number one, gets Kuro. Will he go for more? He's pretty low on the mana. And in fact, pump fake on the charge of Zai.
Because he doesn't, it's so incredibly hard for them to fight right now. CTY rolls in, all he'll do is run into a brick wall.
Not hard for Secret. There's the charge onto DDC. No cold embrace the time he gets stunned. The cooldown's there. Pretty good one. Connects on two. Looking to focus Arteezy, but Puppy's ready in position with the grave. And out comes the Requiem. Dodged by the Phoenix Egg, but to what avail? As they grip ZYF, they'll bring him down too. Arteezy juking for all he's worth. Did they even get him? The last remnant barely takes him down. But was it worth it? 4 heroes collapsed, the tower still falling.
You can really take the fight here.
It is a very game-changing combo, but like you said, not the easiest to hit. There's 4 ranged heroes on Secret.
It's just the tankiness of their lineup. They're actually just going to have to surprise Secret, try to take
it. Oh, this could be the fight.
They're coming up the ramp.
They have a vision. Call down coming through as well. And it's a 3-hero Winter's Curse. Locking them in place. No egg coming through just yet. He doesn't have mana. No mana from ROTK. Oh, no. Can he hold on? He gets up the egg. And they're not actually focused. It's Secret. All of them are back. They're getting the advantage now. Kuro could be next. Lanham slept up, but they should be able to get off the track here. Trying to die quickly. Track gold more and more piling in. Ehom found a pretty good fight, and now they hunt for Arteezy, who's dangerously low. Tracked up. Long range ball. CTY got him. What a pick. Now Lanham backing off onto S4, who quickly tries to turn this one around. TP out. Not going to make it. Secret do salvage the fight. They make it a 3-for-2, but when there's track gold in play and when you're that far ahead.
Nick's ultimate, no supernova there. Could have been very scary for Secret if he had mana. It's getting to the point where RTK is, he's really crippled in this regard, but onto the middle lane, there's the jump on Puppy, the silence is there for the Arcane defensive sleep.
Kuro was looking for it, but he couldn't quite get it off. Now
they want to take this fight.
They bait out the egg off the bat, but the Winter's Curse prevents them from killing it! And now Secret can fall back! The egg's gonna go off! They're blasting him with the Phoenix Ray, and forcing S4 off of the fight. Arteezy has Requiem mana though. BKB is starting to wear off. Can they turn this one around? He gets the first kill on RTK. He looks for more, but it's too low!
Oh, that chilling
into him! Secret down. They've almost got S4 as well. He's gonna die again. The lone survivor, Arteezy Shadow Feed. The combo just so strong for Ehom.
The good news though for Secret is that Ehom have a pretty terrible pushing lineup.
Four step in, they're gonna start the fight that way. Lanham looking for the plays to begin it, but it's S4 and he's a little tanky. RTK says, let's go. Zai is gonna be the first man at the same moment. CTY jumps Kuro on the backside. He looks to blow up the bait off the bat, but the man from Arteezy keeps him alive. RTK wins kept alive as well. These defensive support plays making a difference. And now, the egg, Boulder Edge, can they kill it off in time? They do barely, just barely. Arteezy will pop like a pinata. He's down for 90, it's a buyback again, the sleeps.
Fearless comeback for them. Very well played, and they're not done just yet. They track S4, Arteezy and S4 fighting against the world, but any moment now they could get jumped in. And the Eve home chants erupt. We might be in Key Arena, but you wouldn't know it from how hyped this crowd is. S4, the next man jump. It's CTY again and again. He might even go for more here. Ah, objectives. Objectives is the call. Take the Rex first.
Touche.
All right, Secret, they're going to go for the GG.
This is the desperation
right
smoke. Do they get the initiation they're searching for? It could be a great winner's curse. DDC is going to hold it. They go into DYF as well, and they keep Arteezy in position. The egg! The egg's there in the middle of everything, and nobody's focusing it. S4's going to go down. Puppy on the run. It goes off. Kaboom! And Zai next. He's surrounded. There's the GG. But Secret will die before they can get out of this game. Another five-man wipe, and a devastating takedown for EOM here to get on our second match of the day.
And what a game it was. That Storm Spirit, that's what I'm talking about. The Storm plus Bounty Hunter combo, you really can't underestimate that in Secret.
The last pick is very difficult here for Secret.
It's quite impressive.
5 seconds remaining. Oh, they're down to 3 seconds, goodness gracious.
And they used, that's really what they needed. They needed AoE control, and they needed a bit of pressure in the game.
It's been true for a lot of the younger players as they rose through the scene. He actually left the game for a while. He started to play League of Legends, but man, he's back in a big way. We might have a rumble here off the bat. It's ZYF up in front, taking some initial harassment for Puppy, and three heroes are going to come in. They get off the Battle Hunger. Just really wanted to secure this rooted. CTY engaging, but the cast will bounce. Oh, this could be bad for EOM off the bat. DDC, the body block from Zai. Very nicely done. The flip, not going to save him. And Secret get right back to work, taking the first blood and grabbing the bounty rune there. Although Arthur, ZYF, deep behind enemy lines. If S4 stops for this camp, oh,
he's gonna actually run behind him.
S4, and they came from behind! Oh, ZYF making the plays. This is how Secret normally play. They really push it to the limit with their farm advantage. We saw it a lot through the group stage. But EHOME have been reading that, and they're looking to punish it. And now they want Puppy. Grave's about to cool down here, but he's so much on his own. Even if he gets the Grave off, he won't. CTY looks to lop his head off, but it's actually DDC, the man to get the last hit. They're chasing a bit for more. Uh-oh, Kuro in danger here. The cast bouncing. Beautiful bounces from Kuro, but a follow-up trap, and they continue pursuit. In comes the anti-mage. RTK fairly low on Monty. He's going to surge his way forward, still healthy in terms of HP. And they silence RTK, and they focus some time. 5 seconds to go. The Grave, I don't know if it's enough. He runs the other way. Last stop,
they
take it. They
so
get out of Blink. He makes it. RTZ survives. They surge. No vacuum. And now the turn. S4 marching back.
He's got the move speed advantage.
There's the casket. It's going to bounce once to CTY. That's all they need for DDC. One more auto attack. They pound him down. ROTK also forced to run. Secret bouncing right back.
DDC is at this top lane right now. It's not easy.
He wants his level 6. He really does. There's the trap coming in mid. The denies there. S4 with a good start to the fight. TP's going to come. But Calldown was ready for this. Arteezy runs away. It only connects on Kuro. And now they pound him aside with the Rocket Barrage. Almost had his health gone.
Lanham's
surrounded, though, in between two. Not that tanky anymore. Even Arteezy going to get involved. But this leaves S4 to the Wolves. There's the Grave. Well placed to cast. That bounces beautifully. The wall zoning some of Secret back. But Arteezy rushes in. He tanks the Rocket Barrage. He's got to blink away. And blinks to the south. That leaves Zai to be left for dead, and he'll be collected in the end by CTY. But oh, they found Kuro. He's way in deep. He does have a teleport scroll. Lift is ready, and they've also stolen the cast. They've got two ways to stop the TP. They'll start with the lift, and that's all they need. EHOME, it just feels like they're the stronger fighting lineup right now. You start to lower your farming speed by a substantial
amount. Oh, but a top, Zai's ready for this.
They're looking for the jump in. They've got the play call. It's on to ZYF to go. The death ward to follow, but instantly canceled by RTK. Medical assistance has arrived, and they're going to turn it. EHOME now hunting for S4. The TPL will be canceled. No Void. They got him. He's down as well. Three, crumble. ROTK, the man of the hour.
Right now, whereas Kuro and Puppy, they're playing the guessing game. You saw at the top and here in this mid lane, they have no idea this is coming.
They're going. They're on to S4. The back's there. The cooldown to follow. He's completely surrounded. Doesn't even get off a spell, but the Grave, it allows for a Requiem to turn this. And on to RTK to go. The Death Ward keeps on going. CTY trapped in the trees. He's got to get out and help the team.
Oh,
they
he's
lose
stuck.
Two.
They know too.
Oh, the Blink will cool down, but the damage is done. And Arteezy says, wonderful. I'm going to cut the wave top. This tower will be mine.
They overextend again. Arteezy's just going to get so much space.
That's going to be like pretty much a Butterfly or a Basher after, or even close to an Abyssal Blade after one really bad fight.
Yeah, with this lead, you can't really throw it away, especially when you've got such a mobile hero.
They have the blink. Live to follow this up. Call down is waiting as well. They're going to immediately force out the blink. They couldn't quite get the silence off. Arteezy could have mantled it anyway. Zai. Fishing with his own blink call. He's not going to connect the urn, stopping a potential blink out. Now they silence him. Anti-Mage Illusions working on the carries here. Zion, a bit of danger. S4 there to usher them away, but blinking forward. Is CTY the crit? That not coming crit. Out, but the fact now! S4 Grave, the beautiful call! And the Deathlord looking to go! Kuro with the damage! Not enough, though. Now he's on the run, too. S4 may also fall as RTK. CTY cutting off the path of retreat and executing Secret inside their own base. Heroics were attempted here, but body still hitting the floor in numbers, and with a lone catapult mid, they may just try to high ground it now.
Oh, was just gonna go for bottom.
They want
bottom. Blood right now. They realize even if S4 has a buyback, he can't really do anything with just nine souls on him right now.
The time grows desperate. Where does Arteezy go? If he goes mid, there's a tier two. There's a glyph. If he cuts the wave bottom, it's too late. There's already a gigantic wave in here. There's no Requiem on Shadow Feet, no BKB, no buyback either. They only have a buyback on the Witch Doctor, who's lacking a Death Ward.
Oh,
Secret
just
trying to force cut the waves, but it's really not going to matter. They can't actually threaten Rax here. They can't even threaten tier threes. He blinks back towards mid, trying to prevent an additional lane of Rax from falling. But Ehome, they strike gold again, they get yet another objective, and they zero in on what would be a crushing upset if they can take this 2-0.
Hollow is the same.
Zai making me nervous here. Now the Blear Blink. S4 slaughtered, he can't even make a move. Oh, Jesus.
He does have the buyback, but it'll be with 11 souls.
Arteezy even walks into this, he's gonna try to start the fight. There's the 2-0 call.
Oh, CTY doesn't have Vegas.
Unavoid, oh, he does end up going down. 800 gold going up his way. Secret RTK frantically scrambling. Ehome have to be nervous now. The Conan comes in. Gyrocopter arriving and looking to hold the lines. Stand strong, Ben, but there's the Kuro Death Ward from the high ground. Pounding into ZY up here. Back, turning on Arteezy. Can he win the fight? He looks to blink, but he's got no manta. And ZYF bails them out. Now the blink. Ion Shell, Kuro down. Even with the miraculous of most miraculous fights, it pales in comparison to the raw damage output of Ehome. And without even a second of hesitation, Arteezy,
the Satanic, and he would have the damage to back it up, but...
Or at least to be a threat to the supports, if nothing else, in these fights.
Oh, Arteezy, he's gonna get caught out here. He has the Banta, though.
Oh, he's thrown to the low ground. That's pretty fortunate. Now the turn. Arteezy, one auto attack, blinking out, but it's Zai who's left behind. Zai in a bit of trouble. Can he make his way out? There's the Ghost Scepter desperately hanging on. But the going back in! Arteezy, he charged in again. It'll pay with his life. And with no Arteezy, this is going to be nigh impossible for Secret. Massacred under the blazing guns of ZYF and CTY's endless crits. There's another Ehome. Ehome. Ehome have done it. They 2-0 Secret and they move forward here in the winner bracket. A shocker for Secret and fans around the world. But what a solid showing it was.
I mean, Ehome took care of business. Neither of those games even looked particularly close. In the first game, Secret had the advantage, but Ehome staying strong. And in that second game, I mean, I thought Secret was going to bounce back.